This is my mom, not my older sister. And a few years ago, my mom saw something on a Korean reality TV show, and she was convinced that we had to go to Iceland. So we took a few magical pills, knocked out, and when we woke up, we were in Wonderland. The next 9 days were going to be the best memories with my mom that I'll never forget. Our first stop was, of course, the Blue Lagoon. We put silica mud on our faces, and I drank legally for the first time. And also, my hair turned into literal hay afterwards. I didn't always know where we were going. But my mom always led the way. So the best way to get around Iceland is by renting a car and traveling along the ring road. From there, we did a lot and a lot of driving. And getting lost. And more driving.
Uh-oh.
Sometimes the road got bumpy. But we got through it. And sometimes it rained. But it was only because of the rain that we got to see so many rainbows.
Oh, it's going away! Oh.
They didn't last very long, but that's what made them so special. They even showed up indoors on the walls of our hostel. Every day we drove somewhere new, and along the ride, we'd always take a moment to stop. To stop and take in everything that surrounded us. Or to stop and take pictures. My mom loves taking pictures. We took literally a gajillion. I was fascinated by the water in Iceland.
Oh!
Pretty blue.
I even got a taste of the water. We also saw a lot of waterfalls wherever we went. Something about being under the pounding sound of a waterfall weirdly comforted me. I always like taking risks.
I try not to be careful.
But my mom always wanted me to be safe.
Oh, Jiona, 가지 마.
Our typical meals weren't very fancy. We had a lot of instant noodles. And we used whatever utensils we could find.
Oh, this is good.
Including our hands. For breakfast, we'd have instant oatmeal. For lunch, we'd make instant soup and rice balls. And we take it with us on the road. And whenever we could, we'd get an Icelandic hot dog, which is honestly a must try if you ever go.
Okay. Oh yeah, it's been long.
Not everything went perfectly on this trip. There were a few technical difficulties. My camera fell multiple times. And I spent 2 hours searching for my lost drone. My mom was half terrified that I would trip and die, and half fascinated by all the sheep around us.
Alright. Do you see it? Do you see it? Don't go!
No, it's okay. We can get another one.
Eventually, I found it, and I was very proud for not giving up. The car tire also had to be fixed. And I accidentally dropped my phone in the toilet.
Whoa, you opened it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's wet.
Yeah, it's wet. This is everything.
Do it long enough so the heat seeps through and gets to the glue. So
she's alive.
I tried charging it.
Yeah, I wanted to charge it.
But every obstacle gave me something.
It's not turning on.
Because I didn't have my phone, I spent more time looking up. Or down. Or even through a filter. Everywhere I looked was like a panoramic postcard.
Beautiful.
Hi. One night we stayed up till 3 a.m. hoping to see the aurora.
Even though it's like white.
The forecast wasn't very promising, but it was like a miracle. It was like under 30 degrees and I was freezing, but I'll never forget that night. Then it was time to head back to Reykjavik where we started. But first, we have to wash the car. And then nature washed the car for us a second time. Every night, we had a different home. After a long day, we just kind of fall together. It made me happy to see my mom get excited.
And then built-in
dishwasher.
Wow. Whoa.
Oh,
each day, the home got better and better. On the last night, we accidentally got upgraded to the top of the suite.
Oh my god, this isn't even the bedroom.
It was pretty sweet.
Oh, look at this!
Then we celebrated our last night by having a few drinks and my first ever 5-course meal. And on the next day, it was time to head back to our best home. I don't know if it was the drinks or the food coma from the night before, but it all still felt like a dream. I just want to say that I'm so thankful, and I love you, Mom. Thank you for everything.